Hello students, this is our third and last part of our chapter Democracy and Diversity, class 10th, Civics. In this chapter, we studied about how the social differences prevailing in the society sometimes when are exaggerated and overdone by the people can lead to social divisions which are very harmful for the unity of the society. We studied about how people can be different in a society depending on their birth or their economic status, their religion, or even their way of thinking. Regarding the same, we studied about the types of social differences, cross-cutting social difference and overlapping social difference, and within these, how cross-cutting social difference can be accommodated, whereas overlapping social difference is a threat for a society. Now we'll study about how, when social differences are added with the politics, how can they lead to different results. First, if we look at the social divisions in the society and mix them with the politics, the first reaction will be of a very dangerous one, because when these two are mixed, the results are usually very bad. We studied the example of Northern Ireland in our previous lecture, where the social division in the society was not accepted in a healthy manner. This social division, when added with politics, led to a disastrous result in Northern Ireland in the later period. There are majorly two groups, the Protestants and the Catholics. The Protestants are in majority, whereas the Catholics are in minority in Northern Ireland. They are both supported by different political parties as well. And the demand of both the groups is also very different. The Catholics, because the majority population used to reside in Northern Ireland only, so they wanted to be in those parts of Ireland, and they wanted to be unified with the Republic of Ireland only. Whereas the Protestants wanted to be a part of the United Kingdom, because the differences in both the groups were completely opposite, and to add to that, the people were not willing to compromise something for the other group. This resulted into a disastrous blast, and many civilians and military people were killed and massacred in the civil war which prevailed afterwards. It was only in the year 1998 that both the groups came to a peace and the struggle was stopped. With this example, what we want to say here is that if the differences are not accepted, then the result may be bad, but if the differences are added with the political desires of the people, then the results can be disastrous and they affect the whole community in both personal and economic matters. In this example, we get the idea that if the differences are not accepted, then the results are bad. But ultimately, they reached a peaceful result and harmony was sustained. But the same consequence is not met by many other examples that we may find. In the previous chapters, you have studied about the example of Sri Lanka, where the ethnic difference of Sinhala speakers and Tamil speakers could never bring the state into a peaceful condition, and continuous disturbances are witnessed there. Another similar example is from Yugoslavia, where because of the addition of politics with the religious and ethnic differences of the society, the country was disintegrated into 6 different countries. So the results, as we take from the examples throughout the world, are not very good at first, but there are examples also which will tell us that if politics is adjusted with the social divisions, differences, then they can lead to a better result. Also, the example of Belgium can be placed here, where an acceptance and adjustment within the community resulted into a better future for the people and for the country. We can take the example of our country as well, India, where different religion, different communities, different languages are living in a harmony because the politics is not severely involved into using those social differences for their personal benefit. I'm not saying that it is a completely flawless political system. Yes, the politics tends to use the social differences for their benefit, but on a bigger view, we have accommodated the social differences in a far, far better manner than the examples that we are seeing here. So if social differences and politics both lead to a bad result, then should be the answer of this question be that there should be no social differences, everyone should be following the same thing, following the same religion, using the same language, or should the politicians be saints and do not use the social differences on their benefit? Is it possible? No, it is not possible in practical life. So, what could be an option for a better result? There is no complete riddance from the social differences or its use in politics, but yes, it can be controlled in a particular manner. We could use certain determinants to guide and to control the social differences and politics and reach a peaceful state in a rational manner. First of all, the individual will have to put an effort to recognize himself. If I say that I belong to this religion, I am superior to everyone else, I am not like the others, if I try to use a singular individuality, then this will result into seclusion and separation of myself from the rest of the society. And if this is followed by everyone, everyone in the society, then the society can never come together as a single unit. We have to accept our multiple personalities, that okay, you belong to this religion, okay, you belong to this caste, you belong to this state, you belong to this country. So rather than confining yourself into an identification of your religion or your caste or your name, your language only, we'll have to accept our multiple personalities and define ourselves with all of them in a combined manner. If we are able to do that, it is only then we'll be able to accept others with their multiple personalities as well. If we do not do this, then we'll be stuck within our box of thinking and will never be able to involve others into our way of thinking, our way of working, our perceptions. So multiple identities will have to be accepted by the individual. The second determinant, and to say it kind of defines if the nation is going to work in a peaceful manner or not, is that the political leaders will have to choose rationally how they are going to raise demands of any community. We see during the elections that the politicians, they relate themselves with one social section and they try to use the demands, the needs of that social section as a ladder to reach the seat that they are fighting for. But sometimes what happens is that they overdo this and try to seclude their possible voting community from the rest of the community who may or may not vote for him. When this is done, then a seclusion is created in the society of the individual who want to vote for one political leader and of those who want to vote for the other political leader. This in the long run may be bad for the community in a whole. So what is required to be done here is that the politicians will have to raise the demands of any community, keeping in mind that they do not underestimate or they do not suppress any other community, or they are not breaching into the rights, the status of any other community. It is a very dicey work because it is very difficult to be rational and be concerned about the community when you are standing at a political stage and yearning for votes. But it's something that has to come from an individual's conscience only, and it has to be implemented in a proper manner. The third determinant is how the government reacts to the demands of different groups. here it is a very important job for the government also that they should not prioritize or they should not privilege one community over the other. It has to be balanced, and if it is not done, then the results can be similar to the results of Sri Lanka, like we saw in the previous chapter, where one group was in majority and they suppressed the minority group completely and barred them from any opportunity. So the results were disturbance in the country. If the government is using the power to balance the rights of the different communities, the demands of the different communities, then it is very easy for different communities, different social groups to live in a peaceful manner. If the government is not doing so, then the results will be similar to what we saw in Yugoslavia or Sri Lanka. So with this, we studied how social divisions in a country should not be seen as a danger. Instead, they should be accepted in a very healthy manner, because if there are no differences, if everybody in the society follows the very same thing that any other one in the society, then it will be a very monotonous type of society, which is not a natural way of living. The differences in the society are what that increases the beauty of the world, and these differences should be accepted in a lively and a very healthy manner. It is then only that called a single society of different groups.